Very good morning, my dear students. Welcome back in your English class. Again, your favorite teacher is here. So today we will do the word body of this chapter and explanation of this chapter. As you all know, this is a poem and this is a very interesting poem. So see here, just everyone get ready with your course book. This is your course book, just open, and today we start chapter 12. See here, children. First of all, before starting this poem, I want to tell you that there are very few words that we have to understand and what the meanings of these words. So, first one is fences. Okay. So, what is the meaning of fences, my dear students? Fences means imagination. Fences means imagination. So, it's very simple. That sometimes we are sitting in the class, our teacher is explaining something, and we are in the world of fences, imagination. When we were reading the chapter that Simba the Sailor, so I hope that you were visualizing the pictures that Simba in the valley, deep valley, and the snakes were there. So that was imagination, okay? And next one is maths. Maths means goes out of two meanings of maths are there. Okay, for example, when ice cream, we are having ice cream in a bowl, and you see after some time what happens, it melts. Okay, but here the meaning of maths is goes out of focus, goes out of focus. Okay, and let us start the reading of this poem, and then we will find out some other words that also we will do in this poem. Hold your pencils in your hands so that you can go through the chapter carefully. Okay, so here we go, children. What's the name of this chapter? Books. As you all know that books are very important for us. Okay, they are just like good companions, good friends. When you are alone at home, you can just use a book and it can provide the best company. Okay, and these books are the treasures of knowledge. Now, so many things, whatever we are doing today, that we are doing because of the books. Because we are gaining knowledge from books. No doubt our elders, our seniors, they are also just giving us awareness. They are also providing us knowledge. But no doubt, books are also very, very important for us. Okay, so let us start this chapter. See, do you enjoy reading? Yes, definitely. My all students enjoy reading too much. And we were in the class, we were already eager to read the chapter. May I read? So, today I will read the chapter and you just concentrate on your study. Let us see. Read on to find out more about the wonderful world of books. Okay, so different types of books are also here. There are comics for enjoyment that you are reading, for entertainment, general knowledge books, and books related to different subjects are there. Okay, so let us see what happened in this poem. What worlds of wonder are our books? What worlds of wonder are our books as one opens them and looks? Means they are full of surprises. So many things are there. New ideas and people rise in our fancies and our eyes. Means whenever we read a book, we are in the world of imagination. Okay, and we see different people. When we just read about them, then what happened? We started imagining them. Okay, we imagine them. And means they appear just like we see that we started visualizing them. We start visualizing them, that they are in front of our eyes. So, the doom we sit in maths away, and we find ourselves at play with someone who before the end may become our chosen friend. Means we are so much involved in the characters that the characters who are in the poem, who are in the chapter, who are in that story, they in the end of the story, they become just like our friends. So, or we sail along the page to some other land or year only. Means if we are talking when we read chapter, if we talk about the past time, so we are in the past, we think about the early man, how he was living in the caves and deer, how he was just eating the wild fruits and all the things, how animals were there. So what is this, Peta? This is just imagination. So when we are reading the book, we find ourselves in the same place. If we talk about the past, so we are in the past. Okay? So, or we sail along the page to some other lands or age. Here's our body in the chair, but our mind is over there. Okay? Physically, we are at the same place where we are sitting. For example, the class, you are sitting and your teacher is explaining. Now also, you are listening to me. I'm explaining this chapter. But you are also thinking about different things. When I said that, if we talk about early man, so that you were also visualizing about that early man. I'm sure, okay? You were thinking, no? Right? So, same happens. When we read the book, we see all this, those things in our imagination. We visualize them. Each book is a magic box which, with a touch, a child unlocks. In between their outside covers, books hold all things for their lovers. What the poet wants to say? That books are treasures of knowledge. All the things, whatever we want from a book, whatever we need, all the things are inside the covers of the book. For example, this one is cover and this one is cover. If we will open this, we will find all the things. We'll find stories, poems, okay, some realities also, many facts are also given in this book. So means a book is having all the things, but what we have to do, children? Yes, my smart students, we have to open the book. We have to start reading. We have to start developing the habit of reading. We have to develop the habit that we should read books every day. At least for half an hour we should read, okay? So it will improve our vocab, also vocabulary, okay, our reading habits also, and we will enjoy it also. Okay, and it will develop your habit of making spellings also. So I suggest you, whenever you are getting a time, just purchase one book, except with this syllabus book, and you can start reading those books. Okay, so this is all about books, that how books are important for us. We should read, and when we read books, we find ourselves in another world. Okay, sometimes we are in the past, and sometimes we are here, and sometimes we are at other country, in other country. Okay, so this is all about the books. So tomorrow we do question answers of this chapter. I hope you understood this, and students, just once again go through this poem so that you can understand it well. It's very interesting and very easy also, and try to speak recite this poem also. So that's all for today. Thank you, children. Bye bye.